Okay. Time to get inspired. Restricted in current session. What? What mod's doing that? Oh, hold on. I just started Funky Town again. Okay, quick explanation. It's 1886, right? We are in September, which is here, okay? Things have happened. So, first, Mercedes-Benz. Back in January. The first ever. Where is it? There was a. Maybe it wasn't here. Maybe it was a little later. Oh, here we go. This guy here. He won the first World Chess Championship. Pretty cool. Clap, 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 clap. Awesome, right? Cool. Father Augustine Tolton, the first Roman Catholic priest in the United States to identify himself publicly as African American. Wow, that's awesome. Nagasaki incident. What? Chinese troops riot during shore leave in. Whoa, holy shit. The Christian Union also formed. That's cool. Massive hurricane demolishes Indianola. Good riddance. And then we have George Zucker, born in January 11. What kind of name is that? Oh, he made not he made he made films. Okay, whatever. And so we are in 1886 in September. We are in this little section of the world right here, in this little lake right here, this one here called Lake Teletskoy. Okay, and we're somewhere in here. I'm not gonna give a specific area where, but we're in the mountains of the Altai Republic, which is a small part of Russia, today and also was before. The current guy who runs Russia, this man right here, this guy right here, him, this guy right here, this dude, Will Alexander the Third. He's the guy who's currently in charge of Russia, and he will be for a while. Maybe not. Who knows? We'll find out. He was coronated only 3 years ago, which is kind of crazy, kind of whatever, right? So why is this year important for this place? It's the year that they officially get ratified into the Russian books. This is the first like recorded day that they're actually in the books. Okay, bye. And so here are the mountains of Kinaspol. And you're also seeing the water of the lake that the village is attached to. And of course, here's the river. You know, there's a lot of nature here. It's a lot of untouched land, a lot of forests. From pine, birch, chestnut, oak. You'll see a lot of the leaves on some of the trees, and the other cinematics are like all sorts of gold brown, all that. Yeah, so this is what the place looks like. Let's go check on past me, past Ion, and see how he's doing loading up the game. So let's get some Russian accordion music. Balalaika music. How do you say that?
Balalaika.
Balalaika, okay. Oh yeah, right. Wait, isn't Laika the dog that went to space? Did they name it after the guitar?
The new car.
That's a fucking ad. I was trying to do a bit, and it. So the Laika is the dog, and the Baralaika is.
The new car.
It, again! The Hungry Jack ads are everywhere, I swear. Very nice, very nice. This little patch of birchwood forest is where we're starting. Why here? Why here? It's a lot harder to navigate through these waters here. I mean, you can go through here. You can probably just go through this here too. In fact, I don't know why they wouldn't pick this area. In fact, yeah, why wouldn't they pick this area? This is a lot better than over here. Okay, so this first building that I'm making here, and I'm doing a little bit of a Beyblade there. This first building is going to be a farm. At first, when I was starting to build it, I didn't know if I wanted it to be like a wheat farm, a cotton farm. Though I did start straying towards some sort of food. This ended up being a cattle farm, and it was originally going to just be for meats and leather, though I ended up going with a dairy farm. So, this is just me getting a chimney into the house. So, back in this sort of era of time, back in the late 19th century, especially in Russia, in rural Russia, the Industrial Revolution and a lot of the technology, electricity, stuff like that, had not reached the people. So this is a lot more like a medieval society, but with some of the benefits of better refined technology. And in this case, far more established. This backyard, this plot I'm doing, I start and then I realize makes no sense. Back in the times of old, backyards and yards were just, no one did them. The only reason you built a fence was to keep animals in. Fences and private property aren't really a notable feature. They aren't something that people don't have private property. Instead, a baron owns the land, and they lease the land for labor. And all of the peasants would give their laborers payment for living on the land. In this case, the baron would obviously be taxing, like, meats, dairy, all that sort of stuff from the farmer. And maybe some leather, depends. The baron just chooses the tax and what he taxes. Anyways, so this fence that I'm doing here, I'm actually going to get rid of the backyard fence later, but this fence here is actually the first pen there, you can see, and it goes into this little stable. It's going to, the stable itself would be the milking area where the farmers would bring the cows in. I'm just making a few more plots because, you can't just have cows graze on the same pasture, they'll eat all the grass, you have to give it time to grow, so they do a bit of pasture rotation. This isn't a realistic size, but Cities Skylines is not very large, so having something like that is just completely... having something too big and realistic size would just mean half the map would just be, or even like two-thirds of the map would just be farmland. I put a little wind rotor down. It is a bit more futuristic for the timeline. Well, it's a very appropriate for the timeline. There's also a well there that they'd use to mostly for themselves and the cows, but other people would be using that well. And the trees as well for apples and pears. Some foods are grown by the families and they, you know, just have it. I'm just adjusting a few things here and there. I eventually get rid of that wind rotor because there's no reason for it to be there. I originally put it there because it's the aesthetic of a farm, but it's actually not used. You wouldn't have one there. The only reason you'd have one is for maybe pumping water or using it as like a... using it to power like a grindstone or a sewing machine, but... That's all too fancy for this. This is an isolated Russian community in the late 19th century. The Industrial Revolution hasn't happened, and that's kind of what spurred on the Soviet Union. The whole... So a lot of, like, updates, and here's me just, so it's fall, so all of the trees are, you know, whatever. I'm just taking away all the biggest trees and replacing them with saplings, to indicate that, the trees do get cut down, and they get replaced, because they need firewood. It's Russia, and it's not the coldest parts of Russia, but they still have winter and they still have to go through the snow. So that'll be in a future episode where everything will get snowy. I've just built the farm now, and I'll come back to it later. And now we're building this is a much smaller plot. This family here is actually They work with milk, and they produce dairy products, and in this case, I went for cheese. There is a specific kind of cheese, which I've forgotten the name of, but it's essentially a lighter version of Gouda. And this is the storefront. Usually, you don't have a lot of when you get food... in these times, usually you'd either go to a market, or you just rock up to the person's house and just, like, grab some, right? There's not really... the concept of money and exchange for profit is just not a thing. Like, no one does that. there's not really a reason for it, because you'll grab cheese off one person, you'll grab they'll grab something off you. There's not really ever a sense of monetary value. Now, the reason why there is a storefront, though, they don't actually sell anything. Well, they don't sell it for profit. It's just sort of an announcement that this is where the cheese is made, and it's where a lot of the cheese is displayed. Cheese is, I'm going to say cheese so often, but the process to make cheese requires, and specifically this kind of cheese, requires aging, right? Which is why that little warehouse is on the side, which I completely forgot to mention. That's where all the cheese sits in paper, a parchment-covered or maybe wax-covered molds, and they'll age there for a while. I'm just making a sign here for the storefront, because it needs to be in Russian, because it's not... This is in England. There's my mouse fucking up trying to... There we go. So you can't just eat cheese. You can eat some sorts of cheese, like mozzarella. You can eat... what's that Greek? Feta. You can eat feta pretty early on without aging it. In this case, you can eat it, but it is much better served aged. So there has to be a store where someone tells you what the age of the cheese is and what kind it is, so you can't just go and grab what you want. So they need a storefront, in air quotes. This is more just like a supply front, really. Just imagine it more like that. And here's me just doing the backyard plot. I get rid of this fence as well because it's not needed. And we do a few sunflowers here. A big crop in rural, especially in this part of Russia, is sunflowers, flax, and other things like that. So oil, fibers, you have like wheat grain. These are just some of the flowers that are native to the area. And then I obviously put some fruit trees. Fruit trees are very common in rural areas. You'll see them all over the world. Fruit trees just give you fruit, which is nice. And there's some firewood there as well, because everyone has to go through winter. It's not like down the street's any different. And so here's another farm. This one here is a grain farm. You can tell it's wheat. I also specifically made sure it was the grown version. It's early fall, so a lot of the a lot of the crops will be ready to harvest. And that'll be something we also come into as well, like harvest season. And usually harvest season comes with festivals of sorts. Harvest festivals are very common all across the world, and we'll definitely have one here. Making up the plotting for this, and with a farm of with a wheat farm, usually they'd be large as well. They would be larger than cow pastures, but it's all sort of the scale for things is more just representative rather than actual. Because you can't really get an actual scale for things in City Skylines. And just also being a bit economic with my placement of these things, so that I'm not using too many props. Problem with these, though, the fields, is that they don't like to stick around when you move your camera around. It's just really awkward. So you might spot that in cinematics and that. I'll just do more of the trees. Actually, I should explain this. So you might know, and you might have seen, a lot of trees line farms. For cow pastures, it doesn't make too much sense, though it does still provide you with some firewood for the seasons. It will not make up the whole amount that you'll need. You'll need more trees than that, but the main reason for it is to stop dust from flying in off like wind and such. You'd be protected from dust. It also attracts birds, which are nice. They're just pleasant. And then also, you have a bit of shade as well. The main reason for it, though, is to stop dust from hitting the hitting your farm, hitting your crops. No one likes to clean a dusty house like 3 times a day. And with a lot of open space, dust can collect really quickly. It's a big deal. It's why we use a lot of trees in farms to, like, line property. It just protects a lot of the it protects a lot of the crops, and it protects a lot of your property from becoming dirty and dusty. All right, so here's the farmstead. There is two homes here, and a lot of people might consider that the idea that since this society is fairly egalitarian and agrarian, and it's also a feudal time, there shouldn't really be a difference in status, but that's not true. Though it kind of is, it wouldn't be true normally. It is kind of true in this case, though. The only reason that the two houses are different is because one was made way more recently for a much smaller family, and the other one's a much larger family, and it's been around for a lot longer. You can hazard which one was built earlier and which one isn't. If you can't, it's the smaller one was built more recently. It's made of, I think it's actually made of stucco, but I'm declaring that it's actually just a yellow dye paint on dried up mud and thatch. So that's another thing. Building materials. A lot of building materials, or at least having a presence for them, is very important. What I'll be doing in future episodes is addressing that. For instance, you'll see stone, clay brick, shingles, lumber, stuff like that. You can't just poop it out of existence. It has to come from somewhere. It comes from a lumber mill, it comes from a brickyard, you know, it comes from a kiln, stuff like that. A mason has to chip it away, more trees and all that. So that's something that will come in later episodes, but not right now, because there's just so much that needs to be built. Just fiddling with the props on this building. Just sort of notice it now, a bit late. The barn that's here, at first, it was just supposed to be the farmer's workshop, where the farming families would store all of their tools and stuff like that, but then it is a bit large. We have a windmill. This one actually isn't the one I sit with. It doesn't spin, which is sad. So I went for a different one. And also it was really weird with its terrain conforming, made a procedural object, didn't spin. That one didn't spin when I made it a real object. So yeah. So I grabbed a different one. Oh, that's just me doing some, random, thing. Here we go. This is the one. Now, if you're really keen-eyed, you might spot it. This particular windmill is very Dutch in design, which I want to say wasn't an accident, though I was completely aware of it the whole time. The thing is, it has an explanation for why it has the Dutch flag painted on it. On the railings, you might see it there. It also has it under the cone roof. It has one there as well. And it is also just very Dutch in design. You can't really tell, the hallmarks of a Dutch windmill, but you can tell when you see it, right? The reason why there's a Dutch windmill in this random Russian town is because actually a Dutch engineer came to this town a long time ago and built it. And it's been here for a long time. And just by tradition, they just keep the paint. Every time the paint gets a bit too faded, they repaint it. And it's just a reminder that that there is a bit of a connection with the Dutch. And historically, the Russians had a lot of connections with the Dutch back before they became the Soviet Union. And this here, this is another shop. So we have the flour, we have wheat that becomes flour in that mill. This is where the flour ends up becoming bread. This is the bakery. We're doing the storefront here as well. Same thing with cheese, you can't just eat raw dough. So you need someone to tell you and show you which breads you can eat, which ones are ready to eat. It is technically a storefront, and in the game, as you can see, it is actually a store. You have to use those little blocks so that the game knows that there's a shop there. Procedural objects don't count as buildings. And with most professions, people will live and work in the same place, right? So the baker and their family would all live in this house here. Oop, my mouse isn't working. With the first floor mostly just being used strictly for baking, and then a little staircase out the back that gets you upstairs to the actual living quarters, which is covered off by that facade. And again, most of the materials here are all pretty much similar to each other. The reason why there's a lot of mismatch between the roofs, the type of walls, the colors, and everything like that is because most people build their own houses, right, in this time. So the materials they get are just going to be whatever they can get. And it'll change a lot as well, season by season, year by year. Some houses won't have any bricks in them. Some will use a certain kind of shingle. Some will use a certain kind of frame. And some will use different kinds of glass, depending on what's available. Because it's a very low... like, most buildings here are built very infrequently. You'll have houses be built maybe once every 5 to 10 years. Not a lot of progress happens in the time up leading up until now. So you're not going to see a lot of houses that are similar or even built out of similar materials. They'll be built out of the same base stuff. Like, you'll have stone, you'll have clay, it'll become bricks, but they're not going to be the same thing. The mason is always going to be experimenting, trying to find new ways to make things. Same as the lumber mill. There's always going to be a different kind of paint, and people kind of embrace that and just paint their houses differently. You can just tell which house is which, mostly just by the color of the house. You don't even need to... I mean, you can even use the architecture as well, that too, but... Oh, wait, Pass Me has something to say. You know what I should do? I've got a great idea. So I have a mod that I haven't worked on yet. But I could totally take... She's phased from the wall. Okay, cool. I'll totally take suggestions for, like, names of people, places, and other things like that. And I have a mod that... Oh, another person. Well, I don't mean to be racist, but... There weren't a lot of black people in 19th century Russia. Oh, remove the citizen. Wait, what is this thing? Whoa! Holy shit! He got 139! What the heck? Whoa! What the shit? Okay, man. But yeah, look at that. We actually got people walking around doing their thing. It's so nice. Okay, thanks Past Me for that one. This is pretty much the end of the video. It kind of feels like a lot that I wanted to do is just not done yet. Like, there's a lot of things I have planned. You just seen some nice shots of the farm there. You probably noticed a bit of the wheat fields clipping in and out again. I can't fix that. That's just an unfortunate... There it is again. Just an unfortunate part of the game. But I am really happy with how everything turned out. It looks really nice. And it's really capturing the sort of vibe that I'm going for. Like, it is a bit of a mismatch. That's kind of the point. It's going to only get more and more of a mismatch. This place is going to have an identity of no identity. Kind of. Yeah. Hard to explain, but you'll kind of get it as time goes on. And we are going to progress through time, because trying to build in late 19th century Russia is really difficult. But yeah, here's one of the coolest shots. See all the cows doing their thing, walking around. If you see how the... you might have spotted it there. That cow was walking a little bit funny. I think it's kind of funny. It's a little adorable too. Yeah. Here's that wheat field. It looks really nice, sort of capping things off. I'm gonna keep that sort of chaotic style. Make this village really flesh it out. Next episode, I want to work on one of a few things, a little stutter there. I'm either gonna be working on a lumber mill, which I already sort of earmarked a location out for, a brick kiln, or a dock. I might leave that one for later. And yeah, so that's the episode. Eventually we're gonna take over all this land. So yeah, do all those YouTuber things, like, comment, subscribe, favorite, follow me on MySpace. Kisses and love. Bye.